Good morning students. Today we study chapter 2 addition and subtraction. Addition and subtraction. First we will study addition. You know what is addition? Then we add to addendum. That is add this 3548 then 4329. Then we add this. Then this number is addend, or this number also addend. The result of the two addend is called sum. The result of two addend is called sum. Now we add this number 8 added to 9 17, then carrying 1. Then 1 plus 4, 5, 5 plus 2, 7. Then 5 plus 3, 8, 3 plus 4, 7. Then our answer is 7877. This is called sum. What do you say? Sum. Then addend, the first number is addend, the second number also addend, the result of the two addend is called sum. The result of two addend is called sum. Now we have to, for example, find the sum. Find the sum. 7550 and 3748. Again, 7550 and 3748. Now, first you write ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000. Then, first you write this number 0. You start with ones place 0, 5, 5, 7. Here, 8 4 7 3, then we add. Then we start with in ones place, we don't in thousand place, we start with in ones place. In right hand side we start with 0 plus 8 0 added to 8 0 plus 8 8, 5 plus 4 9, then 5 plus 7, 12, you write 2, then carry over 1. The next place you write the carry over. Then 7 plus 3, 10, you take the carry over also. 7 plus 3, 10, 10 plus 1, 11. Then which is our addend? 7550 is our addend. Then 3740 is our also addend. The result is called 11,298. This is the sum. Another example, add. Another example, add. One more example, add 3420 plus 1359. Again, 3420 plus 1359. Then again you write ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000. Any? Then you arrange this number 0 2 4 3. Again this number also arrange 9 5 3 1. Then add this number 0 plus 9 9, then 2 plus 5 7, then 4 plus 3 7, 3 plus 1 4. This is our sum. Understand all students? One more example. Yes, you write one more. Yeah, another example. 9375 add 2478. Then again you arrange this according to place value. Again you arrange this number according to place value. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000. Then 5739. Here also 8742. Then add this number. 5 plus 8 13. Very good. Carrying over 1. Then 7 plus 7 14. 14 plus 1 15. Carrying 1. 3 plus 4 7. 7 plus 1 8. Then 9 plus 2 11. Understand which is the addend? Which number is the addend here? 9375. Then 2478. Both are addends. Then the result is 11,853 is the sum. The result is also called sum. Then properties of addition. Properties. What are the properties of addition? Properties. Properties of addition. First property is ordering property. First property, ordering property. First property is ordering property. In ordering property, the two numbers are added. The two numbers are added in any order. The result is not changed. The sum is not changed. Order in ordering property. The two numbers are added in any order. The result is not changed or the sum is not changed. That property is called ordering property. That property is called ordering property. First, for example, here, look here all students. 4735 plus 3140. This is our number. Then first we add this new number. Then ones, again you arrange this number. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000. Then you write 5 3 7 4. Again 0 4 1 3. Then add this number. 5 plus 0 5 3 plus 4 7 7 plus 1 8 4 plus 3 7. This is our one. Now we change this 3140, we write in first. We write in first here. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000. Then we write 3140, write in first. 0 4 1 3. Next 5 3 7 4. Then add this number. 0 plus 5 5 4 plus 3 7 1 plus 7 8 3 plus 4 7. Both answer are same. Look here, both answer are same. Yes or no? Yes. Now this property we change the order. First we write 4735, then second we write 3140. This order is changed, but the result is not change. The order is change, but the result is not change. This property is called ordering property. What do you say this property? This property is called ordering property. Second, then this property is, then you fill this number 4175 plus 7150 is equal to 7150. Which number we write here? Here blank. Which number we write here? Which number we write here? 4175 write here. This property is called ordering property. Second property is called grouping property. Which property? Grouping. Grouping property. In a grouping property, the sum of three or in a grouping property, the sum of three or more numbers. In a grouping property, the sum of three or more numbers, we changed the group, but the result is not changed. The final result is not changed. In a grouping property, we changed the group, but the final result is not changed. That property is called grouping property. That property is called grouping property. For example, here first question, 378 plus 450 plus 175. Here three numbers here. First group, we group this number 378 plus 450, then bracket plus 175. Again look here, 378 and 450, first we add this two number, therefore we put a bracket. Okay, first we add this two number, then here add this 378 plus 450, then 8 plus 0 8, 7 plus 5 12, carry over 1, 3 plus 4 7, 7 plus 1 8. What is the answer? 828. We take this number 8 2 8, then we add 175. 8 plus 5 13, carrying 1, 2 plus 7 9, 9 plus 1 10, carrying 1, 1 plus 8 9, 9 plus carrying 1 10. This is our sum. This number I also change this number. First we write 400 plus 175 in bracket plus 378. The group is, I change this group. Okay, listen here, again look here, 450 plus 175 plus 378. Now we add 450 plus 175. Add this number first, 0 plus 5 5 5 plus 7 12, carrying 1, then 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 1, 6, then 625, then 378, add this, 5 plus 8, 13, carrying 1, 10, carrying 1, 10. Here, look here, both the final answer is same, both the final answer is same. This property is called grouping property. Understand you grouping property? In a grouping property, three or more numbers we changed the group, the final result is not change. The final result is not change. That property is called grouping property. That property is called grouping property. First property, ordering property. First property, ordering property. First, what is ordering property? Again repeat. In a ordering property, we change the number in any order, the result is not change. The sum is not change. Grouping property. We two or more numbers are grouped in any order. The final result is not change. That property is called grouping property. Next, identity property. What is identity property? Third property is identity property. In an identity property, when we add a zero in any number, the result is we get the number. In identity property, we add zero in any number, the result is we get the number itself. For example, 9378 plus 0 is equal to 9378. Understand? 1 lakh. Again you say 1 lakh plus 0 is equal to 1 lakh. Understand? We add 0 in any number. We add 0 in any number. We get the number itself. The number itself. The result is the number itself. These are the properties of addition. What are the properties? Again, repeat. First, ordering property. Second, grouping property. Third, identity property. Again, ordering property, grouping property, and identity property. Understand this? Now we you do the homework exercise 1 and 2. Exercise 2.1 and 2.2 in notebook. Okay. Then how to word problem, how to use the word problem in our really word problems. You suppose there are 3748 boys and 4370 girls in a school. Then how many student, total how many students in a school? Then we write the solution. First you write the solution. Number of 3748 boys and 4370 girls in a school. What is the total? What is the total students in a school? Then you read the there are 3748 boys and 4370 girls in a school. What is the total students in a school? What is the total students in a school? First you check, first you read the question, then you what are the words come in question. First what is the total, what WH words are not come in statement, which are WH words are not come in statement. What, how much, and find. These words are not come in statement. What are the words not come in statement? What, how many, how much, and find. Again, what, how many, how much, and find. These words are not come in statement. Here which word come in? Total. Therefore this question is add than together. Together also come in question, this also addition. How to identify this question is add and addition. This question is addition. How to identify you? You check any total is come, any together is come, any total is come, any together, total, all, in all. This word also come in question. Then together. These words come in question. You identify this question is addition. This question is addition. Then first we solution write. First we write. We will write first a number of boys. What we write? Counting. Countable this. This is boys is a noun, countable noun. Therefore we write number of boys is equal to 3748. Next line, number of girls is equal to 4370. Then what asking in question, what is the total students? What ask? What is the total students? Total ask. Therefore this two number we add. Then we add total students. Then we add this two. 8 plus 0, 8. 4 plus 7, 11. Carrying 1. Then 1 plus 7, 8. 8 plus 3, 11. Again carrying 1. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 4, 8. Our answer is 8118. Now final answer. This is solution. Final answer. Hence. Which word we use? Hence. So therefore these words are we use in final answer. Hence. What is the spelling of hands? H-E-N-C-E. Don't write H-E-N-S. You write H-E-N-C-E. Hence 8118 students in a school. Understand this, how to write the statement? All students understand? Anybody ask you question? One more question. Yes, right. In a village. In a village. In a village, there are in a village 375,485 men, 248,300 women, and 143,150 children. What is the find? You are just to change we what we change find. Find the total population. Total population in a village. First, what do you read the question? In a village, 375,485 men, 248,300 women, and 143,150 children. Find the total population of the village in the village. Population of the village. First, your solution. Number of men. This also countable. Men is also countable. Number of men is equal to 375,485. Then number of women Two lakh 48,300. Then number of children 1,43,150. Then add this number 5 5 plus 0 plus 0 5 8 plus 5 13. Carrying 1 1 plus 4 5 5 plus 3 8 8 plus 1 9 5 plus 8 13 13 plus 3 16 1 plus 7 8 8 plus 4 12 12 plus 4 16 1 plus 3 4 4 plus 2 6 6 plus 1 7. Right. Total population. Total population is equal to 7,66,935. Then final answer. Hence, 7,66,935. The population of the village. People in a village. People be. Understand? All students understand this? This is the word problem solved. Thank you for listening me. Any doubt you ask? Okay.